Hello children, in this video we will get to know how we can insert and use images in OpenOffice Writer. So first we will get to know what are the different ways to insert the image in OpenOffice Writer. First method is drag and drop. So for this you have to make the size, you have to reduce the size of your document like this. I am reducing it like this. Okay, I have reduced the size of OpenOffice Writer and I'm just picking and dragging the image in my document. Right, now you can see. So this is the first method, drag and drop. Okay, now I'm going to delete the image now. Now the second method is to insert the picture by using the insert menu. So we have to click on insert menu and then click on the picture option. Okay, when we will click on the picture option, we will get two options, from file and scan. Right, if you have scanner attached with your system, you can go for scan. Okay, and access the picture from scanner. Right, so here since I don't have the scanner attached with this, so I'm clicking on from file. Okay, so from here you can give the right. I want to search my picture. See, and then click on open. Right, so this is the second method. We can insert the picture by using the insert menu. Right, now next method is inserting an image or picture from the clipboard. So I'm going to delete this one. Okay, so what is this? Inserting an image from the clipboard means we will copy the image, we will copy the picture and then paste it in the document. We know that when we copy anything, it gets pasted in the clipboard, right? And then when we use the paste command, it comes from the clipboard to our document, right? So here I'm going to copy and paste the picture, right? So just Control C for copying the picture. If you forget the command, then just right click on the picture and then click on the copy option, right? So here I am going to press Control V. So this is my copy and paste, right? Now the next way is, okay, the next way is inserting an image from the gallery, right? So here on the standard toolbar, you can see the gallery icon is given. I click on this. See, the gallery icon has come. Gallery window has come, right? So choose. You can choose the pictures according to your requirement. So I have clicked on computers. So just click on this and drag it in your document. You can see, right? Okay, or you can right click on the picture and then click on insert. Okay, fine. So both the methods you can apply. Okay, now this is, now you can see we have inserted the picture from the gallery. Fine, so these were the different ways by which we can insert the picture in our document. Now we will see how we can modify the picture, right? So I'm taking some other picture for this again. I think this one is better, right? Having lots of colors. Okay, so you can see here, this is our menu bar, then we have standard toolbar, then we have picture toolbar, or you can say formatting toolbar. Okay, so when the picture is selected, you can see the pictures icons are available here. The formatting icons are available here, right? So I am going to use these icons. Fine. So here we have graphic modes, right? So different graphic modes are given here. Okay, when you will click on this, you can find grayscale, black and white, watermark. So I want my picture grayscale. You can see the color has been changed, right? The picture has become gray now. Fine. Okay. And if you want to make it black and white, click on the black and white. See, the picture has become black and white, right? Okay. And if you want to make your picture as watermark, click on the watermark. See, now the picture has become watermark, right? Now again, I'm clicking on the default. Okay. So graphics mode, in graphics mode, this is the graphics mode window. In graphics mode window, we have got the different options: grayscale, white and black and white, and watermark, right? Okay, then we have filters, right? Okay, when you will click on the filters, you will get the different options. See, invert. Okay, invert option invert the color values of a color image or the brightness values of a grayscale image. So I'm clicking on this invert. You can see. Okay. Default. Now, next is smooth. This is smooth. Smooth softens the contrast of an image. When you click on the smooth, you can see. जहां पे भी कंट्रास्ट है वो हल्का सा स्मूथनेस आपको उसमें शो होगी, राइट? देन वी हैव शार्पन, इट इंक्रीजेस द कंट्रास्ट ऑफ एन इमेज. यू कैन सी देयर इज वेरी स्लाइट चेंज इन द पिक्चर. ओके, नेक्स्ट दिस इज रिमूव नॉइज, इट रिमूव्स सिंगल पिक्सल्स फ्रॉम एन इमेज. Very slight changes this. Then you have the solarization. Okay, it mimics the effect of too much light in a picture. When you will click on this, see, from here you can increase or decrease the value. Fine. Okay, now I'm making it undo, right? Now, next we have aging. Okay, so it makes the effect of time on the picture, right? When you will click on this, now see, so your picture is coming black and white. You can see this, right? Okay. And we can apply aging several times, right? Okay, then the next option is posterize, right? It makes a picture appear like a painting by reducing the number of colors used. Now you can see again posterize, if I'm instead of 69 making it 40, not 140. 50. Right? So the picture will appear like a poster. If you want to increase the value, you can increase the value instead of the 16. I want 100. Okay. Fine. Then we have, this is pop art. It modifies the picture dramatically. Fine. Control Z. Then we have charcoal scale. It displays the image as a charcoal sketch, right? See. Now Control Z. Next you have relief. Okay. When you will click on this, you will get a window of relief. A dialog box is displayed to adjust the light source that will create the shadow and hence relieve the effect. Fine. Like this, right? Then. Next we have mosaic. It joins the group of pixels into a single area of one color. See. So, Control Z. These were the different filters that we can apply on the picture. Fine. Now, this is flip horizontal and flip vertical. We can flip our picture horizontally and vertically. When you will click on the flip horizontal, you can see it is flipped horizontally, right? Again, see, earlier the boy was on the left side and girl was on the right side. Now when you will flip it horizontally, see. Okay, so when we use the flip horizontal, left hand side goes to the right hand side and vice versa, right? Now we will use flip vertical. See, so when you will click on flip vertically, top becomes bottom and bottom becomes top, right? Okay. Now we have the transparency. We can increase or decrease the transparency of our picture. Like I'm making it 50%. You can see the picture has become more transparent. If I'll increase the percentage, see, it's not visible. 70. Okay, so from here you can increase or decrease the transparency of your picture. Fine. So by this way we can, now we will use the other options. Like when you will click on the picture, right click on the picture, you will get the picture option. Click on the picture option. Here you will get the picture dialog box having number of options that you can apply on your picture. So first I am going to click on the crop tab here. See, right? This is my crop tab. So if you want to crop your picture, you can click on the crop option. Fine. Now in the crop window, you can see I have got two options: keep scale and keep image size, right? So when you will click on the keep scale, what will happen? Keep scale is when we will do the cropping of the image, the image does not change the scale of the picture, right? The scale of the picture remains same. fine. And when you will click on the image size remains constant. Okay, so जब आप keep scale पे करोगे and you will click on the cropping, okay, when you will do the cropping of your picture, okay, so it will, the picture will appear according to the cropping, fine. And when you will click on the keep image size, what will happen, the picture is cropped but remaining part of the picture will increase or decrease to maintain the original size of the picture. So first we the keep scale is already selected. From here I am going to crop the picture. You can see from left, see this much will be cropped, from right this much will be cropped, right, top and bottom. See, okay, click on okay. See, right, so it has been cropped, fine. Now we will use the next option. Keep image size, right? Okay, so when I'm deleting some part from the left, some part from the right, okay, and then click on okay. Now you can see the picture, the part of the picture is deleted but the size of the image is same, fine. Okay, the size will remain same. Why? Because I have clicked on keep image size, right? Fine. So these are the two options, keep scale and keep image size. Okay, fine. Now see, if you want to provide the border to your picture, what you will do, click on this border styles which is present on the formatting toolbar, or you can say picture toolbar, and click on the size of the border that you want in your picture. Like if I want this, and then you can choose the color of your border, fine. Again from here, border color yellow, fine. So in this way you can give the border to your picture, right? Okay, now you can resize your picture by using the green size, green resizing handles. You can see these are the green resizing handles, right? So like this, you can resize your picture by using the green resizing handle, fine. Okay, if I'll use the resizing handle of corner one like this, I can increase or decrease height and width of the picture at the same time, simultaneously, right? जब आप corner का resizing handle use करते हो, ठीक है, तो आप हाइट और विथ दोनों एक साथ इंक्रीज एंड डिक्रीज कर सकते हो लाइक दिस, फाइन. और इफ यू आर यूजिंग द सेंटर रिसाइजिंग हैंडल, अगर आप सेंटर का रिसाइजिंग हैंडल यूज कर रहे हो, तो हियर यू कैन सी आई एम इंक्रीजिंग द हाइट ऑफ द पिक्चर ओनली, ओके, और हियर आई एम डिक्रीजिंग द विथ ऑफ द पिक्चर, सी, ओके. So center के जो resizing handle होते हैं उससे आप particularly height और width को increase और decrease कर सकते हो, but जो corner का resizing handle होता है उससे आप दोनों को simultaneously कर सकते हो, right? Like this. So in this way we can resize our picture by using the resizing handle. Fine. Okay. can see. Okay, to retain the original proportion of graphic, shift plus drag the image. Okay, shift plus drag the image. If I'm clicking on the shift button and I'm dragging the image, right? Release the mouse button before releasing the shift key. Right? Agar aapko picture ka original proportion rakhna hai, then you have to click on when you are resizing your image, then click on the shift button and then drag your picture. Fine. Okay. Now we can also rotate a picture. How we can rotate a picture? See, Writer does not provide a tool for rotating a picture. Okay, but we have different options by which we can rotate a picture like this. Click on the file menu and then click on the new. From here, either I can click on the presentation or I can click on the drawing. So I am using the drawing. Fine. I have opened the Open Office Draw. From here, I'm going to insert the picture. Okay, I'm taking the desktop one. Pick. So I'm taking this one. Right. Okay, so in drawing toolbar at the bottom of the window, select the rotate icon from the effect tier of toolbar. So you can see this is your effects. Click on this and then click on rotate. Fine. Let me increase the size of my. Let's see. Okay, now click on this and then click on rotate. Now you can rotate your picture. Wait, let me reduce the size of the picture first so that we can see its rotation. Okay, this is my picture and I want to rotate my picture, right? So you can see here. See, you're rotating your picture like this. Okay, in any direction, I'm moving it at 360 degree. Fine. Okay, let us suppose I have rotated it like this, and from here you can control C and you can copy it and paste it in your document, right? So I'm going to paste it in my document here. Control V. So you can see I have got rotated picture, right? So in this way you can rotate the picture and then you can paste it in your document, right? Now we will insert the drawing object in our document. So I'm going to delete this one and this one. Okay, so you can see the drawing toolbar at the bottom of the document. If the drawing toolbar is not visible, you can make it fixed by clicking on the view tab, right? And then click on the toolbars. Okay, and in the toolbar click on drawing toolbar, right? Click on drawing toolbar. Fine. See, so we have the different options in the drawing toolbar. Okay, so if you want to set the properties of the drawing object before you draw it, how you will do this? मुझे क्या करना है, इसको draw करने से पहले ही इसकी properties set करनी है. देखो, I am just going to select one and will show you. I am taking this one. Okay, so it has come with the default color and default properties, right? Okay, and if I want to draw the drawing object before selecting, I want to select the properties first and then I want to draw it. What I'll do, I will click on select icon here, right? And from the drawing and from the formatting toolbar, I will select the different properties that I want in my color. Okay, and then magenta. So I have taken the color. So now I'm going to choose again similar smiley. So you can see it has come with the properties that I have chosen earlier. ठीक है, ओके. तो इस वे से आप क्या कर सकते हो, सिलेक्ट करने से पहले ही प्रॉपर्टीज को सिलेक्ट कर सकते हो. क्लिक ऑन सिलेक्ट एंड देन चूज योर प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक स्काई ब्लू एंड देन आउटलाइनिंग. Green. And then I'm clicking on the star here. Fine. So you can see fill color is yellow and then outlining is green. Fine. Okay, if you want to write the text in your drawing object, click on the text, right? Fine. See. So you can write your text and you can also do the formatting of your text. Click on this and then increase or decrease the size. Fine. So in this way you can write the text in your graphics. Fine. Okay. So if I want to make the grouping of my objects, what I'll do, I have taken this star here, okay, and I am taking one smiley. Okay, now when you will drag this, you can see they are different, they are not attached. Fine, they are not attached, but I want to group these objects together. So what I'll do here, click on the shift button and then select it. Fine, right click, click on the group option and then click on group. Fine, now when you will drag it, you can see now they are grouped. Okay, and if you want to ungroup them, again click right click and then click on group and then click on ungroup. Now see, when you will drag it, they are separate now. Fine. Okay, so in this way you can group and ungroup your picture or your graphics, right? So this is all about how you can insert the picture and you can modify the picture.